can be due. Okay, so let us see about the transportation in this video now. So shall we get into the lesson, children? Yeah. So basically we know the plants can prepare their food by a process called photosynthesis. So for this process, plants require carbon dioxide and water. So this is a basic thing we are studying from our lower classes. If you heard the word photosynthesis, immediately we get this thing in our mind. Carbon dioxide plus water is going to give the glucose plus oxygen. Okay. So the leaf take in the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. So water along with minerals is absorbed from the soil through the roots. So it is then transported upwards to the leaves of the plant. So this also we know. So the leaves are going to take the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, water and minerals from the soil through the roots, and as a combination they are going to prepare the food, and it is going to transport it from leaves to the other part of the plants. The food prepared by the leaves is transported to all parts of the plant including roots. So how this process is going to take place? Through transportation. So transportation is a process in which substances absorbed or synthesized in one part of the plant are moved to other parts of the plant. So this is what the definition for transportation. So how this transportation is going to take place? The transportation of water and food in plants are carried out by a system called conducting system. Okay, this conducting system consisting of two main tissues, xylem, phloem. So this also we know very well. In our 7th standard, the first chapter, we have studied about the plants and animal tissues. In the plant tissues, we have studied detailedly about this conducting system, xylem and phloem. So anyhow, we'll just have a small glance in that xylem and phloem. Okay. So this conducting system, xylem and phloem, also called as vascular bundles. So it is the elongated thick wall, children. So since we have studied about the xylem and phloem in the 7th standard detail, just we have a small glance in that. Okay. So xylem, it is elongated thick wall cell. It is a tubular passage. It is a unidirectional movement. Okay. Xylem is responsible for transporting the water and minerals which is absorbed by the root to the other parts of the plant. So it is an upward directional movement. So it is a unidirectional movement. And the xylem tissues are consist of some components. They are tracheids, vessels, and xylem parenchyma, xylem fibers. So if you take tracheids, they are placed end to end forming a long tube-like structure, and it gives a mechanical support. Xylem vessels, they are also placed end to end. The cell walls are thick and lignified, and it makes a continuous water pipe. Okay. Xylem parenchyma, they are living cells. They are acting as a storage of food and also helps in conduction of water and minerals. So these are about the xylem components. And one more, xylem fibers. So they are thick wall, long narrow cells with tapering ends, and they provide only mechanical support to the plant. The work of xylem fiber is to provide only the mechanical support of the plant. Diagrammatic representation of tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma, xylem fiber. So xylem fiber is also called as xylem sclerenchyma. And the main function of xylem is to transport the water and mineral salts from the roots to the aerial parts of the plant, and it's going to give the mechanical strength and support to the plant. Phloem. So it transports the food manufactured by leaves to various parts of the plant. So the direction is bidirectional, from top to bottom and bottom to top. Okay, so upward and downward direction. So the phloem tissue consists of following four types of cells: sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fibers. So sieve tubes, they are cylindrical cells and they are devoid of nucleus, and they are placed end to end. They are a long tube-like structure. The transverse walls are perforations, and they are called sieve plates. Companion cells, they are living parenchyma cells, and they are associated with the sieve tube cells, which is going to function along with sieve tube cells. Next is phloem parenchyma. They are concerned with the storage of starch, fat and other organic food material. And phloem fibers, they are dead sclerenchyma cells, which is going to give support to the plant. So these all about the xylem and phloem. Just a glance I have given, you know very well about it. Okay, so xylem and phloem together is called as complex tissues. So next is the diagrammatic representation of the phloem. Can you able to see the longitudinal section and the transverse section of the phloem? I mark the sieve plate, sieve tube, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, and in the transverse section you can able to see clearly the sieve tube, companion cell, where it is present, the sieve plate and sieve pores. So this is what the structure of phloem. Next is transport of food. So we very well know during photosynthesis plants are going to synthesize the food in the form of glucose, which is stored in the form of starch. Production is in the form of glucose, but it is stored in the form of starch. So this starch is further transported in the form of sucrose solution to the other parts of the plant. So you can define like this: starch is transported in the form of a sucrose solution through the phloem upwards and downwards to all parts of the plant, including roots. So this is called translocation of solutes. Next is water absorption by the roots. So we very well know that the absorption of water by blotting paper or by cotton dipped in water is absorbed by the property of capillary. Capillarity means attraction of water molecules towards narrow spaces and surface tension. Okay, so this is what normal absorption of water when we are using the blotting paper or any cotton dipped in water. But the absorption of water by the roots, it's quite different from this mechanism. So here, to understand it, we should know what is the structure of root. So the root system of plants consists of a main root which gives out lateral roots. The lateral roots bear a large number of fine outgrowths called root hair. Okay, so the following we are going to see about the root hair, ascent of sap, root pressure. So how the water absorption by the roots are going to happen. So the root system of a plant consists of a main root. This main root consists of a lateral branches, and the lateral branches are going to have a fine outgrowth called root hairs. First, let us see about the root hair. I have given you the clear picture of the root hair. Can you able to see the epidermal cell, cell wall, cell membrane, cytoplasm, vacuole, nucleus, full grown root hair, root hairs beginning to grow out. Okay, see, root hair is a long extension of an epidermal cell of the root. Okay, so it is a long extension from the epidermal layer of the root. This cell, being a plant cell, has an outer cell wall. So we very well know animal cell does not have cell wall, but plant cell, it possesses a cell wall. So since this root is a part of a cell, plant cell, it has a cell wall. So it has a cell wall and an inner cell membrane. So the outer cell wall is rigid and the inner cell membrane encloses the nucleus, cytoplasm and its content. You can able to see in the picture. Okay, so outer part is a cell wall and the inner is cell membrane. Inside that cell membrane we have the cytoplasm, vacuole, nucleus. So the property of cell wall and cell membrane also we have already studied. Cell wall, it is freely permeable. Cell membrane, it is semi-permeable. So cell wall freely permeable as it allows all substances to pass through it. Cell membrane, it's semi-permeable, it allows the water molecules to pass through it but prevents the entry of any other larger molecules. So this feature of cell membrane facilitates the movement of water molecule from the soil into the root cells. Okay, so this is how the roots are going to absorb the water. The cell sap in the root air cell is said to be of a high concentration as it contains more solutes compared to the surrounding soil water. Okay, so this promotes water absorption. The cell sap which is present in the root hair, okay, is said to be having a higher concentration as it contains more solutes in it when compared to the surrounding of soil water. So here it going to promote the water absorption. Next is, what are the speciality of this root ash? So the numerous root ash, a number of root ash is going to provide a large surface area. So more the surface area, greater is the absorption. Okay, so how much root ash are going to present in the root, that much amount of water is absorbed by the particular root system. And root ash contains cell sap which is of higher concentration than the surrounding soil water. So that I have explained before itself. Next is, the cell wall is freely permeable, that is permits movement of all types of substances, but the cell membrane is semi-permeable, it allows only some substances to pass through it. So this also I have already explained. So based on this, we are going to see the three important mechanisms, movements, okay, three important movements of molecules: osmosis, diffusion, active transport. If you take osmosis, it is the movement of water molecule from a dilute solution to a concentrated solution across a semi-permeable membrane. So in otherwise, you can give the definition like this: the movement of molecules from region of higher concentration through a semi-permeable membrane to the region of lower concentration. So when a molecules are going to move from higher concentration to the lower concentration through a membrane, a semi-permeable membrane, then the movement is said to be osmosis. This type of mechanism is osmosis process. Diffusion, the movement of molecules, maybe gas, liquid or solid, okay, the movement of molecule from higher concentration to lower concentration is called diffusion. Here there is no any membrane is going to act here, okay, it's a direct movement of molecules from higher concentration to the lower concentration. Active transport, movement of molecules from their lower concentration to higher concentration requires energy. So here in the active transport, it requires some energy because the molecules need to move from the lower concentration to the higher concentration. So it needs some energy for the movement. So this type of movement is called the active transport. Okay. So next, percent of sap. The water is absorbed by the root ash from the surrounding soil by osmosis process. So it then moves into the inner cells of root by cell to cell diffusion. Okay, so how the absorption is going to take place, just listen children. First is, by the osmosis process, the root absorbs the water, that is the root as absorbs the water from the surrounding. Next, the absorbed water moves into the inner cells of the roots by cell to cell diffusion and osmosis to reach the central xylem, which continues upward into the stem and the leaves. Okay, so this is what, how the absorption of water is going to take place in the root ash. This upward movement of water and minerals, okay, this upward movement of water and minerals are called ascent of sap. Next is root pressure. It is a pressure developed in the root due to the continuous inflow of water because of cell to cell osmosis. Okay, so as a result of this pressure, water enters the xylem vessel and helps in pushing the plant sap upwards. Thus, root pressure is one of the force which contributes to the ascent of sap through stem into the leaves up to a certain height. So root pressure, it's very simple. This is a pressure developed in the root due to the continuous inflow of water. Okay, because of the cell to cell osmosis process. It's a simple definition, you just keep it in mind. This is enough to know what is the root pressure. It is pressure developed in the root due to the continuous inflow of water because of cell-to-cell osmosis. Picture, phloem, xylem vessels, and from the root hair how the water is absorbed and it's transported to the other parts of the plant. Okay, so this is a movement of water along with minerals in a plant. So in a simple sentence you can justify this diagram means it's a movement of water along with minerals in a plant. Movement of water along with minerals in a plant. Okay, so this is what about the root pressure. Thank you children. So with this the transportation is getting over. Part 2 transpiration will be uploaded in next video. So try to finish the worksheet and send it to your respective in charge teacher. Following this video, you'll be getting the worksheet. Okay? So stay home, stay safe, have a nice day. Very soon, I'll meet you with the next video. Thank you.